This video is all about the Master of Puppets, the new feature present in version 102. Most people don't know this window, so I'm going to show you how it works and how to use it. To reveal the Master of Puppets window, you come to this button right here and you click it. Then the window is going to show up. If at first this looks confusing, it is because this is an advanced window. It solves a complicated issue, so it needs a lot of control. Okay, but what does it do? What is its purpose? Well, its purpose is to redirect, to mirror any controller, the state of any controller, to any other controller. That's what it does. Here you can see two columns, the master column and the puppets column. What does this mean? The puppets are the virtual controllers. These eight puppets are these eight controllers here. They are the same. The master column shows all of the controllers detected on the system. They need to be plugged. They need to be recognized by Windows. So if I open here the Windows controllers, the Windows USB game controllers, you will see there are no controllers. Hence, the master column is empty. I'm going to plug a physical controller here, down here in my hands. Plug in. You can see here the Xbox controller I just plugged, and here you can see the same controller, and I'm pressing buttons in that controller. So this sees all of the controllers that Windows can see. This means if I plug a virtual controller, it shows up here too. Why? Because Windows can see it. So controllers in the master column can be puppets too. Remember that. And how do I map my physical controller to a virtual one? This one here is my physical gamepad. I'm going to click it, and then it's marked. And then I select a puppet here by clicking on it. And now the state of my physical controller, the one I have in my hands, which is this one, is mirrored to this virtual controller, and it doesn't need to be plugged. I can map the state of these controllers even if they are disconnected, because this is within the Parsec Soda's memory storage. But a red controller has no use to us because Windows cannot see it, right? So let's plug a puppet here, a virtual controller, or even more than one. And now we can check these controllers, and still they can be used in a game, and we are updating their state. That's how it works. You can even pick several at once. The master can be only one, but the puppets, you can pick many. Okay, now I'm going to switch to SDL because it's usually better. Windows gaming input has its own problems, but I'll get to that later. I'm going to uncheck all of this, to disconnect this, and especially my physical controller, and we're going to start the first example, which is Gauntlet. What we want to do is to play through the virtual controllers. Why? Because then we can switch who's handling each controller with a single press. We don't need to connect and disconnect our physical controllers because that damages the USB port and the controller cable, maybe the controller dongle if it's a wireless controller. So you don't want to keep plugging and unplugging your physical controller. You must remember that. That is bad. So Gauntlet is a 4-player game. So I'm going to plug 4 controllers here, the 4 X inputs, before starting the game. And then I'm going to start the game here. Let's start the game. Good. We started the game, and now we are going to configure it. Right from the start, we face our first issue, which is Gauntlet requires focus. So I'm going to get rid of this problem using fake focus. I open fake focus, I focus Gauntlet, the name shows up here when I go back to fake focus. Then I uncheck all of these and I check just this one. This is the best setup for Gauntlet. If you try to use the other two ones here, it is going to repeat button presses for a D-pad and for other buttons. It's going to be a mess. Use just this one, it's fine. It's the best setup for Gauntlet. Then run, and it's going to accept background inputs. So now we go back to the Master of Puppets window here, and we have our four gamepads, our four X inputs, and everything's fine. SDL is showing up here, a phantom ghost, but don't bother, this is okay, it's normal, and it doesn't matter. So what we are going to do is, we're going to use the virtual gamepad, not the don't plug your physical gamepad yet, okay? Because if you do that, Gauntlet is going to detect your physical gamepad instead of these four virtual ones that we want to use. So use the V-pad and pick the controller you want, and then you press the button, okay? Press start, Gauntlet's detecting, start your session, okay, campaign, everything. Okay, good. Okay, I'm looking at the second screen here. Okay, fine, everything's good. Now we're going to put three more players in this match, and we have our four players all here in the session, and those players are these four controllers. Everything is fine. Okay, so now I'm going to plug a physical gamepad, my physical gamepad, and I'm going to play through this gamepad here using the Master of Puppets. You need to hide the virtual gamepad to use the physical one. So yeah, so see, now everything is working. I can pick any controller I want at any time. If someone tries to mess up the whole game, the whole thing, then you can just remove that player from the game. It's all fine. See, I'm controlling all four at the same time here. Let's focus this. So all four at the same time here. Everything's fine. All good. See? And then if someone is messing up the party, everything is soft lock in, someone leaves the game, you can just like pick that controller from that player and you remove him, like drop out. You have three players, run. You can play with any gamepad you want at any time, everything is good. Change everything on the fly. If you don't want to play anymore, you can just like uncheck the master, and then you're not controlling anymore, and someone may take that gamepad. All good, no problem. Now we start the more detailed explanation. In case you didn't notice, the last controller was an X input. But how do we use dual shocks? This controller I have here is an IPEGA, and it maps as a DualShock, as a PS3 PC. So if you look here at the mapping and the overlay gamepad I have from Patty, if I press A, Parsec Soda is mapping as square. It's mapping X as square. If I press square, it maps as triangle, which is Y. So, in order to fix this, you change the button mapping here, in this button. Here it tells Xbox, but if you press here, then it switches to PlayStation and the button is fixed. The most recent version of Parsec Soda has three mappings: the X input, the DualShock 2 or 3, and the DualShock 4 for PlayStation 4. Then you may want to switch the mapping to your specific controller. There is no custom mapping yet, and that would take some time to implement, to code. I don't have plans to do it, but yeah, this is what we have right now. So pay attention to the mapping from your controller. If you're using Windows gaming input, it doesn't detect DualShock controllers. It only sees the X input once. So remember that too. That's one of the downsides of this engine. And that's why SDL is usually better. And don't forget to like this video, share, comment, subscribe, and click the bell button. STL and Windows Gaming Input, both engines have their own advantages and disadvantages. If you hover over here, over the engine name, you will see a short description of pros and cons, and you can use that to make your decision. STL detects all gamepads and does not require Parsec Soda focus. Windows gaming input sometimes requires you to focus the Parsec Soda window. Actually, it depends on the controller. It's kind of messy, that part. Well, also, SDL has the downside, which is if you have like 4 X inputs and your physical controller is not an X in, it's an X in, Xbox controller or some X input based controller, and there are no more X input slots available in Windows, and you try to use it, there is going to be a downside. You cannot press both triggers at the same time. This is me pressing L2, and look what happens when I try to press R2. It goes down. See, it doesn't press both at the same time. And here in the Windows gaming input, you can see I'm pressing both. It doesn't suffer from this problem, but that SDL suffers, see? But this one only detects X inputs, and frequently it requires window focus. If I try to focus something else like this, let's say this window right here, see, it stops responding. So yeah, there's positives and negatives to each one, and you should test it, see what works best for you, but be mindful of that. Okay, remind that you cannot have it all, basically. And that's limited by the engine itself and by the X input itself. Sometimes the SDL shows ghost gamepads too, but it doesn't. It's not a big deal. It's one downside, but it's not a big deal. So yeah, read all of these tooltips here. Okay, do not skip it because it's important. I've just shown you a recent game which uses X input, and now I'm going to show you an old, very very old game that uses direct input, and that game is Ragnarok Battle Offline. So let's run the settings file, and here it is. And the first thing you may notice is that this game is for 3 people, okay? And I do not have my physical gamepad plugged in here. Why? Because old games usually only detect the gamepads at start. So I'm starting with only these 3 gamepads here because I just want them to be detected. and that makes my life easier. So now I'm going to plug my physical gamepad. Okay, let's refresh here. Good, it's this number 4. And then if I try to set up anything here, it doesn't work because this old application already detected the gamepads, which are these 3, the virtual ones that I really want to use. So now I map my physical controller to the first one, and I come here and I set up everything. And then I set up all of the controllers, everything's good. Same thing here, second. The indices may change, but you got the picture. You set up everything. Pretend I'm setting up everything. I know it's already there because I've done it before, but you got the picture. Yeah, and you set up all the stuff down, left, right, everything. Good. And when you're done, you click OK. Fine. Now I'm going to run the game, and just to make sure the game detects the very same gamepads, I'm going to unplug my physical one again before I run the game. Okay, here it is. And this game, it has a catch. One thing you should notice is that it requires 3 players to press the button at the same time. At first I'm going to use this virtual gamepad, but then I can switch to my physical one. Okay, so one thing to notice, right? Oops, it's here, okay. Is that when I select a story, the game requires me to press the button at all players, press and hold at the player one, and the other players, they have to press the button while the player one is holding. I have no idea why would some dev code a game this way, but yeah, it is what it is. This is the way it's implemented, right? You see there, when I press at the first player, it's going to request me to play at the other, see? And release when everyone is ready. So that's one thing that Master of Puppets solved. You can press at all of them at the same time, and then the party just starts. And you don't need to wait for anybody else to press the button. You don't have to keep holding the button. And then you just map to your physical controller and everything's good. Don't forget to hide the virtual gamepad. Let me reduce this music. Yeah, don't forget to hide the virtual gamepad so you can use the physical one. So yeah, player 1, player 2, and player 3. All good. Perfect. And here we have possibly the best use case for this feature. You can map a range of controllers to your very single controller, and you can press a button and all of them at the same time. See? So if you're stuck in this screen, if you're soft locked because one of these 8 players decided to leave the room, which is not uncommon at all, you can just press start, and everybody presses start.